Breaking news happened about 15 minutes ago. Reported first by our very own Adam Schefter. The Jets have traded Teddy Bridgewater to the New Orleans Saints. And now words coming in that they got a third rounder, which is not bad. So here's the way you have to look at it. The money they gave up that they invested in Bridgewater, that they have to pay Bridgewater, is $1 million. Now, he's going to get paid his $5 million by the New Orleans Saints. Now, Mike Garofalo just tweeted this out, and it does kind of put it in perspective. Remember the deal the Browns made where they took a $16 million contract on?
Yeah, I remember that.
Just to get the second-round pick. Mm-hmm. So, they paid $16 million for a second-round pick. That's how much they thought a second-round pick was worth to them. The Jets paid $1 million for a third-round pick. And remember, they gave up 2 second-round picks to move up in the draft to get Sam Darnold, who now, with the trade of Bridgewater, looks like it's a sure thing that he's going to start on opening night on Monday night. So I think this was a smart move by McCagnan. The only thing that I would question, Don, if you held on to him longer and somebody got hurt, maybe you get more. Remember, Sam Bradford got a first-round draft pick from the Vikings because Bridgewater went down, ironically enough,
right,
for the Eagles. And, Bridgewater's 25 years old, showed that he was healthy. You would hope that that knee is going to hold up. But I think all in all, you could wait, you could roll the dice. But Mike McCagnan said a third rounder in the hand is better than anything
else. Right, and let's also not forget that it was McCagnan that completely wasted the second round pick on Hackenberg.
Right.
So the fact that he was able to go out, pay $1 million for a third round pick doesn't make us forget that, but definitely kind of makes up a little bit for what really was a waste of a pick a couple of years ago. No, I think this is the reason why they picked up Bridgewater. I don't think they had any intention of him necessarily being a part of the 2018 mix. Hope he was healthy and then turn it into a pick. And as far as waiting, Michael, if you wait, and then you wait till the deadline, which is in October, where you're 3-4 games into the season, and nobody gets hurt, then you're kind of stuck.
Right.
Now, maybe somebody would have gotten hurt and given you a first-round pick, but maybe you would have waited till the trading deadline and have to give them away for a 6th or a 7th because nobody got hurt. Third-round pick, I think, is fine. It really is. You paid almost nothing for it. You get to have Sam Darnold, who's been really good in the preseason, be your starting quarterback, the mentor, the guy that was really brought back here to be the glorified quarterbacks coach for your rookie quarterback is in place, and now you get moving. I think this is the perfect thing for the Jets. You should not be happier. A third-round pick, I'm astonished. I really am, because Bridgewater didn't play for the last 2 years. He didn't play a lot with the number ones or against number ones in the preseason. So to turn that around for a third-round pick, I think, is a great job by the Jets.
Now one thing that to me is not perfect in this world, Bridgewater, to me, is a better quarterback by a lot than Josh McCown. I think the Jets obscenely overpaid for a tutor for Sam Darnold. $10 million for Josh McCown is out of this world crazy. If they had not given that sort of money to McCown, then Bridgewater would be the backup. But that would open up a little bit of a Pandora's box. Because since Bridgewater's 25 and has had success in the league, any kind of struggles that Darnold has, which he's going to have as a rookie playing this league, the fans would be chanting for Bridgewater. You've eliminated that distraction or possible distraction. But when you look at it just from a talent standpoint, Bridgewater, far better,
right,
far better quarterback than Josh McCown. So if Darnold, God forbid, gets hurt, well, all of a sudden Josh McCown's your quarterback rather than Teddy Bridgewater. But they're not thinking along those lines. I never understood why they gave McCown $10 million. Who else was giving him that money?
But you were with us when we talked to McCown. This guy is all in.
I get it.
On tutoring the young quarterback. With Teddy Bridgewater at 25, knowing that he was only going to be here for one more year, looking to try to rejigger his entire career, be as much a mentor to the young quarterback as McCown?
But isn't that what coaches are for?
Yeah, but it's nice to have a guy.
Coach, there's not a coach in football. There's nothing John Gruden that makes $10 million.
But starting quarterbacks make double that, right? So
triple that, Aaron Rodgers.
So when the Jets brought him back, there was a chance that McCown would be the starting quarterback, right? If the plan was to trade Teddy Bridgewater, and if Sam Darnold was not ready, Josh McCown would be your starting quarterback, and that's kind of the going rate for, even though he's 39 years old, a quarterback. Plus, the Jets had to spend the money. They're so vastly under the cap, so it really didn't matter that way. Jets aren't hurting for money, so that was kind of the going rate for what they were looking for. And now he can be the backup quarterback, and we know that he can be serviceable. He was serviceable last year if something happens to Sam. But 2018 is about the maturation of the young quarterback to see if they now have the future quarterback. Teddy Bridgewater was brought here to maybe push that and turn it around for a pick, and that's exactly what they got. But I really don't think there was ever a plan, Michael, that Teddy Bridgewater is going to be your starting quarterback in 2018.
You're probably right, unless Darnold got hurt in the first three games. That's the only way he would have been. They would have kept him, I think. According to Manish Mehta of the Daily News, an odd scene, but Bridgewater was on the bus as the Jets were preparing to go to Philadelphia. They weren't on the turnpike at this point. They were still in the parking lot.
Right.
He had gotten wind of the trade, according to Manish Mehta, and made it a point to board the team bus ready to go to Philly at the Jets facility so he could say goodbye. So this guy handled himself very well.
Yeah.
Always smiled, appreciated the second chance he's getting in a career because he almost lost his leg. That's how bad this injury was. And here he is. He's going to back up what is now a 39-year-old quarterback on a team that's ready to win right now. You know, if it wasn't for a freakish once-in-a-lifetime play by the Vikings, they might have gone to the Super Bowl.
Hey, listen, you've got a 39-year-old quarterback that's going to turn 40 in January in Drew Brees. Saints believe that they can be a championship-caliber team, and they don't want to throw their year away if their aging quarterback gets hurt. They've got Savage as a backup. I think Bridgewater is better than him. So it's a good move by the Saints. They do eat, you know, $5 million to their cap, but I guess they were able to fit it in. And now they feel like they've got a guy that they know that can be a quarterback for them if something happened to their 39-year-old QB. I think it's smart on both sides. But a third-round pick, Michael, I think is really great. I know you fantasized about somebody going down and turning it into,
well,
you know, a number one.
Well, that's the gamble you could have taken. That's a gamble.
Still, you know, to pay $1 million, in essence, for a third-round pick after you, you know, wasted the second-round pick on Hackenberg, you traded two first-round picks to move up to three, hey, you need picks in the draft, and now they've got a third round, two second round picks. To be able to get to move up to three for Bradford. So, you know, listen, you got to get stockpile picks, and they did that.